Hi everyone, it's Mr. Demers. Welcome back to another day of Movement and Music Connections. I'm excited today to present to you jazz. Jazz music and dance is an African American art form, and it's an extension of blues. And similar to blues, jazz has a huge history, and there's so much we could talk about. And in 10 minutes, I don't think I can cover everything. What's important is this. Jazz comes from a community of people. It is an expression of these people. And these individuals, specifically the African American individuals, what is prominent to understand is that racism and systems of oppression directly influenced and affected the African American community. And we see this reflection in the art form itself. But what's most important is to recognize that jazz is just yet one more expression of resiliency. Let's now explore the music and dance connections. Have you ever heard of ragtime? Or have you ever seen a piano that plays by itself and it goes do 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 do, and it just keeps playing some music that sounds like jazz? Well, let's take a look at Scott Joplin's The Entertainer. One dance around the time of ragtime was the cakewalk. The cakewalk was a plantation dance in which slaves would mimic the slaveholders. And by mimicking the slaveholders through dance, the slaveholders were able to dismiss it as protest. And like many other African American dance forms, it became a fad all across the United States. Also around this time were minstrel shows. Minstrel shows were a form of American racist entertainment in which white people would often put on black makeup to perform blackface, or sometimes black people would put on black makeup to perform blackface. It's an incredibly dehumanizing form of entertainment. And much like what we're going to discuss throughout our lessons is that the systems of racism impact the art forms that we're viewing and the art forms that were developed. And what we should be taking away each time is a desire to create social change so that these systems of oppression no longer prohibit people from truly living their lives.
And now, our Mr. Bones will favor us with an exhibition of eye-dazzling, leg-spraddling, foot-flapping fantasy. Playing the bones at the same time. Mr. Glenn Turnbull, please the people.
Two early forms of jazz dance were the Charleston and Black Bottom. Let's take a look at and see what that looks like right now. ¶¶ Talk a little bit more about the music. Let's take a moment to review what Mississippi blues sounds like. Now what I want you to do is I want you to imagine that we have ragtime piano and Mississippi Delta blues combining. And this is what is going to be one of the earliest iterations and feelings of jazz music. And so let's take a look to listen to W.C. Handy. Did you hear some similarities to both ragtime and blues in that song? It's amazing, and it's one of the earliest recordings of jazz music that we have. I want to take a moment to also acknowledge a black woman in jazz, and let's listen to Bessie Smith. This is her St. Louis blues.
Yeah.
So from blues music to ragtime to early jazz, the music evolves into swing music. Let's take a look and listen to Count Basie. Now that we've listened to some of the music, let's take a look at the dance. So I've showed you cakewalk, black bottom, tap dancing, and Charleston. Well, one of the things that these dance forms have in common is that they are social dances. And that's because one of the central components of African American dance forms is community. And so this next form of dance is called swing dancing, in which there is an incredible gathering of community and the creation of an incredible dance called the Lindy Hop. Let's look at that, what that looks like, both as a social dance and also as a performance dance. These are some of my favorite videos.
Digging, here comes something now. Wasn't that amazing? I really love to swing dance. And what is important as we end today's lesson is that we walk away with a deep appreciation for the history that we have, and that we can learn from this history to create positive social change in our lives. Again, so that no individual needs to live their life in fear for their life or needs to live a life of oppression. Instead, let us build community, uplift hope, and support one another. Have a great day.